Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show on my favorite day. Today is Friday. You know that's my favorite day, so I get good guests on Friday. Well, I do it during the week, but Friday's my just favorite day. I've got Brian Moody. He's the executive editor at Auto Trader. Now, you told me you liked him when we talked about vehicles the other day, so I brought him back. But he's here to talk about, what are you talking about? Say goodbye to the gas pump. I'll let him explain. Brian Moody, welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show.
Thank you for having me. You're one of my favorites.
Thank you. Now, we'd all like to say goodbye to the gas pump because I got to calculate how much I'm going to spend before I pull it in there. What do you have to help us with that?
Well, electric cars are becoming more and more common. It's not quite to the level of gasoline-powered cars, obviously, but more and more people are willing to give electric cars a try. So, for example, we're talking about the Kia EV6. It's an all-new electric car from Kia, but here's something that's interesting about the Kia, is it was designed to be an electric car from the very beginning. So this isn't a gasoline-powered car that they said, oh, we can also have an electric version too. This was designed to be an electric car from the very beginning, and that's why it looks different and it gives benefits that a gasoline-powered car might not be able to give.
When you say look different, could we see it going down the street and say, oh, that's an electric car? Does it blend in with what we have already?
Well, I think it does look different. And the reason is because if you take a gasoline-powered car and then adapt it for electricity, you still have that big front end. You don't need that with an electric car. There's no big engine to sit up there. The motors can go by the wheels. The batteries can go underneath the floor. It does look different driving down the road than your typical, say, gasoline-powered car that could also be an electric version.
Talk about the benefits and the not-so-good benefits of an electric vehicle at this point in time, because it's going to change.
Yeah, so there are changes for sure. One of the benefits is with a car like the Kia EV6, it has more space inside because less mechanical pieces take up the available space. That's one benefit. Another benefit is that at the source, where the car is driving, there's no pollution. There's no emissions coming out of the car right then. So those are two benefits that you can see are easy to identify with electric cars, especially purpose-built electric cars.
I want my audience to know that Brian Moody is the executive editor for Auto Trader. Brian, what are some of the new technologies? Because, you know, that's why we buy cars, for the new technologies mostly.
Right. So electric cars do have increasingly newer and newer technologies. One of those technologies is the ability to have fast charging, a DC fast charger. So what that means is you could plug the car in overnight. Many electric cars do this, and it takes hours for it to charge up. That's one way. But with a DC fast charger or with a multi-charger, what you get is the option of plugging it into a supercharger, for lack of a better word, a high-capacity charging station somewhere else, and it can charge the battery from 10% up to 80% in less than 20 minutes. So that's a big advantage right there.
All right, then. I'm going to take this question from Instagram. The poster wants to know, with the car being electric, are we going to have enough utilities to support this?
So that's a good question, and the answer to that is we don't know yet, because what we can't do is switch from gasoline to electricity overnight. That's not going to work. So probably the answer would be no if it were tomorrow. But in the meantime, what we can do is we can gradually add more charging stations. We can gradually assess what our electric needs are. And electric cars will always have a place in that. But there could also be a varied approach, such as hybrids or plug-in electric cars. All of these solutions are part of the solution. It's not just one thing or the other.
Brian, I got a feeling we're going to talk about this for a long, long time till we get to a point where we're comfortable. Any place online where people can educate themselves?
Yeah, go to autotrader.com and you can do research on new and used electric cars, but also go to kia.com and look up the EV6. It will tell you the range, and it will give you lots of information. And why I think this is important is because, remember, Kia is not a luxury car maker. They're not selling $100,000 cars. They're selling cars for the rest of us, right, for normal people. And what they do is going to help determine how electric cars go in the future.
Brian Moody, thank you so much. I look forward to our next conversation. I always learn something from you.
Me too. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television, and this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.